What's up, Giants fans, Hub watchers, YouTube subscribers, Twitter, and Instagram followers? It's your boy No Name back at it again with another New York Giants update video. Now then, the Giants signed defensive back special teamer Nate Ebner a couple hours ago. I was actually on time with this on Twitter. I retweeted the Giants official tweet, added my little 2 cents to it and whatnot, but was in the middle of another class, didn't really have time to record a video on it till now. So, Ebner is a very interesting player. He's actually not even a football player when, you know, like regular football players was, I guess I should say. He's a very late guy to come into the game of football. Ebner is like a rugby guy. He didn't play football until college. Until, you know, he was a walk-on at Ohio State, which I'm guessing is partially why he's mostly a special teamer. But hey, this is not at all to say special teams is like a weak part of football or anything. We know that as Giants fans, it's just as important as the other two. But Ebner is very interesting for that reason. You know, he was a walk-on at Ohio State. That was the very first time he played football, and he was so good at it. You know, he inspired his teammates so much that he actually was voted by them the team's most inspirational player, and he got the Bo Rain Award at the end of his last season at Ohio State. And he didn't stop playing rugby either. Like, he's currently a co-owner along with Patrick Chung of the New England Free Jacks, I think it's called, which is a major league rugby team. And him and Chung were at the 2016 Olympics for the US rugby team. So he's a very accomplished rugby player, probably one of the best in the world at the sport. And I'm sure that there's things he takes from that sport that helps him out, you know, to play special teams in the NFL as a American football player, you know, the speed and whatnot, the physicality of rugby. I'm sure that all helps him out. And that same year that he played rugby in the Olympics, he, of course, won a Super Bowl with the Patriots in 2016 when they defeated the Falcons. So the dude's a world-class rugby player and part of multiple championship teams in New England. Now then, there's obviously the connection here with Joe Judge, our new head coach, who was the special teams coach, the special teams coordinator for New England. So in a way, this is probably the closest, like, you know, mentor-mentee type relationship signing that we've had for the Giants. This is the guy that Joe Judge knows the most out of anybody that we've brought in. And a couple reports are even saying that Nate Ebner was one of, if not Joe Judge's favorite player while he was coaching special teams for the Patriots. And that showed if you go and look at some special teams tape where Ebner is like a core special teams player. He's involved in a lot of their big plays. He's involved some way or another where he's kind of like the main guy to play center around, whether it's trying to block a punt, block a kick, you know, on a kick returns, on punt return, whatever the case is, Ebner is always involved in some type of way. And it's because he's very successful as a special teams player. I mean, there's countless times on the field where he's running all across and he's making a play for the special teams. With that being said, I don't expect him to come in and be anything but that special teams player. You know, he's going to be listed as a safety on the depth chart. He's probably going to be a backup safety because as of right now, the only safeties I can think of on the team would be Julian Love, Jabril Peppers, Michael Thomas, who I'll talk about a little bit. And after that, not that much. Maybe some guys are missing on the depth chart, but we don't have that much depth at safety. So he's going to be on there as a backup, but he's going to spend most of his time in that special teams role as a special team safety, as he did for basically most of his career. I mean, like, over the last 3 years, he's only had one time that he played on the defense, one defensive snap over the last three seasons, but played like over 800 special team snap in the same amount of time. You know, he was at kick coverage, punt returns, punt block, all that stuff. He was in there because that's what he's used for. Now, this does kind of remind me of Michael Thomas a little bit, except that Michael Thomas is seen more on defense than Nate Ebner is. Michael Thomas is a very similar player that the Giants already have. Very good locker room guy. I guess I forgot to mention that as Nate Ebner is, not just in college, but in the NFL, he's a good locker room guy. He's a good leader. Same things can be said for Michael Thomas. But Thomas does see the field a lot more than Ebner does. I mean, even for the 2018 season, Thomas was basically one of our starting safeties. 2019 last year, he didn't see it as much as 2018, but he was still on there from time to time because of injuries. So then this does make me question, is Michael Thomas on the way out? I did see an article suggesting that. I don't think he's on the way out because you never hear anything bad from the Giants camp about Michael Thomas, whether it's the players, the coaches, front office, you know, media, beat reporters, whatever the case is, you never hear anything bad about Michael Thomas. Everything they say about him is, oh, he's a really good special teams player. I mean, he did make the Pro Bowl for the Giants a couple years ago because he was playing on special teams. That's how good he is, you know? So he's a really good special teams player. That's what you hear about him. You always hear he's a really good guy in the locker room, good leader. So I don't see there to be any reason for the Giants to let go of him. I mean, his contract is not even, it's not even expensive. It's very cheap. And this Nate Ebner contract is, at least I assume, going to be also very cheap, much like the Cam Fleming contract, probably even cheaper. I mean, as of right now, on Giants.com and other places, I don't see the contract anywhere. I'm sure the details will be released soon, but I expect it to be like a 1 to 2 year deal, around $2 to $3 million or something like that, right? So I don't see any reason to let go of Thomas. Why not keep them both? They're both really good players at their position, at what they do. And in the locker room, I see no reason to let them go. And I mean, that's really all I gotta say about Nate Ebner. You know, definitely another Joe Judge sign. Probably the only Joe Judge sign, you know, the only true Joe Judge sign thus far. Cam Fleming, I have a feeling, is more so a Mark Colombo and Jason Garrett signing. This is the first Joe Judge signing. Definitely the guy he's had the most experience and interaction with compared to anybody else on the team. And I don't really have anything else to say, to be honest with you guys. Good special teamers, good guy to have in the locker room. I'm sure those are the reasons the Giants signed him. And I expect to see a couple more depth chart moves, I guess. We still have enough cap to sign depth chart players and whatnot, guys, to fill out the team, fill out that 53-man roster, which I think is going to increase now because of the CBA. Whatever the case is, Nate Ebner, guys, let me know what you guys think. Special teams ace, good guy to have in the locker room. What do you think? That's it for now. I'm out. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Put your comments down below. Make sure you smash that like button, subscribe, and turn on post notifications. Until next time, I'm out. Yer.